Major League Baseball team, formerly known as the Cleveland Indians for a very long time in the country, is now changing its name for the obvious reasons that they were previously named the Cleveland Indians. So before we get to some of the responses and anger pushback on this, first let's go to how they announced it, what they said, and exactly what the team name is. Watch this.
To keep watch and guard what makes this game the greatest. And together, we are all Cleveland Guardians.
They're the Guardians.
Now, if you look at it, now we can look at some of these images that they've now done for the team name change. And people that are familiar with the team or baseball in general might see that, and this is what I noticed at least, maybe I'm wrong, but the font is very similar as far as the Guardians and the C for Cleveland. But they do have this winged G wrapped in a baseball, and also Cleveland 216, I assume that's the area code, represent 216. You know how everybody talks about the 216.
If you're part of the Bone Thugs, yes, you do.
Yeah, they will talk about it. Right? That's right.
Before we get to some of the pushback from Ted Cruz and also Ben Shapiro, you can expect what they may be saying. First off, do you guys like this?
You know, it's a good change, as they say. I'm gonna say it is a very good change from what it was before. You got like a little God of War, Hermes, what is that? Yeah, like with the little wings around him protecting the ball, you know, it's just like.
It's protecting, I like that it's protecting the ball.
I'm into it. I think Guardians is, it's a good change. It's long overdue. Guardians also sounds dope, you know, it's Guardians of the Galaxy. I don't know what else is a guardian. It's like a parent or guardian, you know.
The Slilwell guy in New York when they had Guardians. Remember the guys with the red berets who were on the. I say guys generic. There's men and women who are protecting New York City. It comes, you know, it's Art Deco, and it's really striking. It comes off of that bridge in Cleveland, mm-hmm. And so you know, it's born of the community. I think it's really great. It's way. Way appropriate. I mean, it's this. The logo was, you know, awkward through the years, and there are Native Americans who really are rightfully offended by it. And I don't mean to sound so woke, but this is an easy one, man. This is really one you need to change. Glad they changed it. As I say, it's Art Deco. It reflects the community. It's a winner.
Yeah, that's what you point out, Mark. When you point out that it comes from that bridge, as we saw in that B-roll there, or at least in the promo video that they put out there, it's so many fun things you can do with it. So these huge guardians over this bridge that enter the city, it still encapsulates the city. It still provides some kind of nature to the heart of the city. And maybe on game days, or say you're in the playoffs, maybe you're going to the World Series, you can throw a Guardians baseball cap on one of those.
Yeah,
like it would be dope. It would be fun, right?
Yeah.
And maybe some people would start to represent the 216 or 7. Wait, let me look it up again. Sorry, Cleveland. It's the 216 in Cleveland. So let's get to some of the pushback really fast. So Ted Cruz tweeted, why does MLB hate Indians? Because, you know, Ted Cruz makes a lot of sense when he tweets. I've said this before, man. Ted Cruz tweets not to make a point, but to make sure that people get mad at him. It's like he enjoys getting verbally or not verbally, actually, sometimes yes. People verbally do it, or just abused on Twitter because he enters with a bad take and he knows it. Like, that was a sarcastic tweet, of course, but he knows that it's just annoyingly sarcastic and not even making a good point. Usually, if you make a sarcastic point, you're making a good point with a joke wrapped around it. Instead, you just make a joke wrapped around a bad point and you just lost twice because no one's laughing.
And ratioing him is only what he wants. It's just like, oh, this is his BDSM at this point. When he gets ratioed, you're just like, I don't know if I should be doing this.
And then he'll make sure that folks maybe give him more money. I see how they treated me on Twitter. Give me money.
Well, I mean, you know, you mock it, and it's very mockable, but it is used for just that. I mean, he wants to be relevant as the, you know, the position against this kind of woke America, you know, the libs ruining everything. And so he does raise money off of it, as well as gain some political currency.
So
yeah, when he bows in front of Robert Mercer and Steve Bannon, or Steve Bannon doesn't have any more money, but you know, like the Koch brothers, they have to sort of show their vials of liberal tears and like, here you are, sir. Here are all the liberal tears I created. Like, these are not enough. Ha! You're like, I'm just imagining how it works.
It definitely works in some kind of money, monetary exchange for sure. Ben Shapiro, speaking of people who got slapped down on Twitter over their points, he also had something to say about this. He tweeted, next on the chopping block, he gives a list of Atlanta Braves, Kansas City Chiefs, Golden State Warriors, Chicago Blackhawks, and you believe it. So that's his tweet, and he went on to say, hardest hit, the Native American after whom the team was supposedly originally named, Louis Saka Alexis, Saka Alexis. That particular person is who's hardest hit by this, and he's really upset apparently. But one user did point out, Manny Fidel did point out to Ben Shapiro after he talked about who's hardest hit and said the Native American. It goes, interesting that you refer to Saka Alexis as a Native American. Is there any reason for that? Weird. So if you want to juxtapose both tweets together, apparently Ted Cruz asked, why do people hate Indians so much? But apparently that answer is Ben Shapiro, because he's woke and he won't use the term. Suckers, man. Again, whenever you have nothing actually substantive or principled to say about it, you just go with the nearest thing. You toss out some meat and hope that people fight over it and blood flies. And that's how you win political arguments in the country. I don't know much longer we can go for this type of stuff, but it's outrageous. And again, yes.
Well, this owning of the libs, it's a real thing. It's been around for a while, but it's now really the only way that there is that you can elevate yourself politically, because you can't do it in any kind of reasonable philosophical discourse about policy or about strategies, you know, governmental and societal strategies. So you go for these wedge issues like this one. They're controversial, and it's owning the libs. Yeah, so I mean, that's how you win.
And if you're giving up your season tickets for it, you were giving them up anyway, and you never had them in the first place.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.